Podcast from the grassroots, connecting people and sharing ideas.
Hey, this is Arlene.
Hello, this is Grace.
And of course, we are back with our second segment, Blast from the Grassroots. Today, we are going to talk about fashion, but not any other fashion. Fashion for the plus size. Oh, actually, plus size shouldn't be that the right word. It should be the normal girl size. So, yeah, we have Fat is Fab, is self-confidence through self-image. We have Tatiana here with us. She is the Fat is Fab committee.
Good morning.
Member.
Good morning.
It's so early in the morning. How are you feeling?
I'm great, great. Top of the morning to everyone.
All right. So tell us more about what is Fat is Fab.
Well, Fat is Fab is an online community group in Facebook, and it was founded by two very handsome gentlemen.
Ooh, gentlemen.
Yeah.
We just talk about Movember, so yeah, anything with men is kind of cool to talk about.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, they started it out because they are photographers and on the line, on the site, and they were photographing models, and they realized that there's only one kind of ladies there, which is not wrong, but they wanted a variety. So they were wondering where are all the plus sizes, you know? So they form up Fat is Fab and gave a free photo shoot for all plus size women. It was open to everyone. And the response was good the first round, and they got good coverage. And that's how it began, and that's how the ball started rolling.
And also, it is a non-profit community group, right?
Yes, we're non-profit. Basically, it's strictly volunteer basis and all based on fundings and helps from people.
So it sort of sounds like it started very naturally by having the photography sessions, and then how you found out how you can actually bring out the beauty from people. Yes.
Because I think Fat is Fat. Well, first and foremost, we do not promote being fat. That's one thing for sure. A lot of people misunderstood us.
Well, you promote people to enjoy eating food. Is
that? Well, I think I promote everyone to do that, not just us big girls, you know. But what we're trying to say is that we promote people to accept people of different sizes, not just fat girls, you know. And we like to educate and realign people to not think the word fat is dirty. You know, it's just another word to describe yourself, you know. And if big girls shouldn't be offended when they are called fat, because you are. So just accept who you are. And once you've accepted that and embrace it and be confident and happy, people will not be so negative on you.
Sorry, I'm a bit blur here. In the fashion industry scale, like, what is actually considered their version of normal size, and what is considered plus size or beyond?
Well, if we're talking about runway model fashion thingy, it would be above size 4, probably. Everything is all like, you know, size 0
sure.
Or plus negative 0. So, but in our world, is I think above size 12 or size 14, that would be plus size. Yeah.
But like you said, Yana, it is very true that, you know, a lot of people have this perception or also idea that, you know, when people are fat, that relates to unhealthy lifestyle. And
true.
Yes. And so it is sort of educating the public as well. So overweight doesn't mean that they are unhealthy.
Well, that's right. I do have to admit that, yeah, the perception is there. And I do have to also admit the ugly truth that, yeah, being fat is not exactly 100% healthy. But what we can do is actually maintain, try to be healthy and continue to be healthy. The perception, negative perception that us fat girls have is that we do not try to be healthy. We do not take any initiative to actually do something about our weight or our health condition. Now, that's the part that we're a bit pissed off. Because I don't think anyone wants to be this way, you know, naturally wants to be this way.
Definitely.
We want to actually be more healthier, much more active, you know. But I know for sure 99% of girls, fat girls out there, they've tried everything in the market to actually do it. You know, it's just sometimes, it's just not the right time yet, or I'm not sure what is their reasoning.
And then sometimes they get all this pressure from the society.
Yeah.
And then
and especially from the media.
The stress unnecessarily from the media as well.
Especially the media. I'm so sorry to say, yeah, it is true, because they actually promote the right size, the perfect size. To me, there's no such thing as perfect size.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody should have their own say on how they want their body to look. Mm-hmm. That is our right, right? And another thing is that while we are actually trying to struggle to actually lose the weight, or if you want or don't want to, the problem that we are trying to actually address is, instead of ridiculing, actually promote, help, you know, and give support, instead of trying to, you know, throwing negative remarks.
Mm-hmm. In Malaysia, when it comes to plus size, what kind of challenges usually they would face besides, you know, scrutiny from the media and, you know, having like negative influences about what is the perfect body from beauty magazine?
Well, I think there's a couple of problems. But the one that I see from feedback from quite a lot of girls is that they are being discriminated for work.
Mm-hmm.
Believe it or not, when they go for interview, they see you're a big girl. Okay, there's that immediate assumption that, you know, she can't move that fast.
Mm-hmm.
Or she's a bit slow, or, you know, she would take MC a lot, you know. So that perception is actually already blocking the person to get to know the person better.
Mm.
You know, so we're trying to actually help that out in that sense. We will have workshops and we will have seminars to help people to, you know, realize that, look, there's more to us than just our size.
Mm-hmm.
And also I think another problem would be, of course, clothes. Because due to the demand and the fashion coverage, we only have the normal clothes. So the plus size clothes are more expensive because it's carried by the bigger designers, the much more famous designers. So right now, that's how Plus Bazaar came about, because we saw that the first step to a good self-image, you know, to try to boost your self-esteem, the first step is the exterior, is to look nice. Because automatically, I mean, I'm sure everybody can relate to this, is when you look nice, you feel nice. And when you feel nice, automatically a certain percentage of your self-esteem goes up.
Mm.
So that's the first part that we're trying to actually address. That you look nice. You know, you don't have to wear baggy clothes all the time or black all the time.
I mean, we are girls. We love to be fashionable. We love to wear clothes that reflect our identity or give a certain statement that we want to project.
Yes, exactly, yeah. Because right now, big girls have this misconception and feedback from community saying that if you're big, you're supposed to wear black. It's very slimming. If you're big, you can't wear patterns or polka dots or whatever. To me, that's BS. To me, it's up to you. Whatever colors you want, what patterns you want. It's just... To me, the best way is get the right cutting for your body. You must know what your body size is. All fats have different sizes. So you must know what kind of shape are you. Then find the right size, right fitting for you. Then any color, you can pull it off.
Another area is accessibility. I still remember, I mean, I'm not even a consider, you know, plus size.
Because,
I would say like normal size, if you are talking about the Malaysian size. I'm not too skinny either, but I remember going to certain shopping malls in Bukit Bintang and couldn't find anything to fit in, because apparently they cater to the Asian size, which is for the smaller size, probably size 0, I guess.
So we're not Asian? I'm a bit surprised. I think that is one of the biggest hurdles big girls have, actually. And the funny part is, a lot of when we came out with Plus Bazaar, a lot of people came up to us and said, thank you for doing this. And most of them that actually came to us are not really that big.
Mm-hmm.
And we're very surprised. They say, what makes you, you know, not go get clothes? They say, oh, it's hard for us to get clothes, especially the curvy ones, you know, with nice bottom or nice top. And
yeah, the J-Lo body, you know? The J-Lo body.
Exactly. So I say, oh my God, what are these fashion... manufacturers are producing? Are they producing all straight cut? No women are straight cut. I mean, everybody's got certain size, certain curves to them. So I'm a bit outraged in that sense.
That's definitely true. Well, you just mentioned about a bazaar that you held before. What are the other activities that you usually do?
Well, before this, if we talk about past events, we had the Plus Bazaar. Then before that, we had the photo shoot, that's free photo shoot. We also have free photo shoot in the Plus Bazaar that is done by our great and generous founder, Aaron Fu. And before this was still, like, you know, makan stuff. But in the, what's most important is in the future, because I do not want Fattest Fat to be known as, you know, oh, there's a group of fat girls that eat all the time. So we do not want to known as that. We will have seminars and workshops next year for self-help kind of workshops, you know, to give motivation, give awareness. And we also have tons of activities, and I don't want to spoil it and, you know, surprise it, give away here. But please do stay tuned with us. And we are fortunate, and we are so happy that we have a few very strong companies that have faith in us and can see our mission and want to jump on board and make this happen. So we are very thankful for them, and we can't wait to announce all the activities that we have for next year.
Yeah.
And we hope that it would help to benefit a lot of people out there, not just girls. Big girl, big people include men as well. It's just that they're a bit shy to come out and say and join in the fun. But I plead to all, come on, big men, come on, join us. You know.
Oh, you have all... a men version as well. I mean, I thought it's
well,
a,
we don't
yeah,
have
all
many...
women.
We don't have many men yet, but in our Plus Bazaar, we do have some men's apparel, plus-size apparel is coming in as well. So we're hoping to rope in some of the men to come in and join us as well.
Mm-hmm. Do you rope in designers as well to participate in creating clothes, trendy clothes for plus-size?
Oh, well, you caught me there. It's a part of the plans for next year, what we have in mind. And we really hope if there's designers out there listening, please do contact us. We would love to collaborate with you girls, with you people, and come up with something that is phenomenal for big people in Malaysia.
It's really an untapped market, isn't it? Especially in Malaysia, if you're talking
literally
about...
Literally, it's a big market to tap on.
I mean, talking about Malaysian women, I believe Malaysian women do love to dress up and look great.
Yeah.
You know, we spend a lot on beauty and on clothing, and I mean, the market should cater to different types of women.
Definitely, definitely. In fact, it's a good business sense to actually dive into right now. I think that's why the spurge of online shops, plus size boutiques and all that just come out of nowhere suddenly, because they know there is a demand there, and they know that, you know, girls, big girls are vain too, you know. Vanity doesn't only, it's not only exclusive for the thin and beautiful, but it's also, you know, for us big girls as well, we want to look nice too. So yeah, they see the market there, the demand there, and right now we really would like to see it in a bigger scale. So, like, you know, an actual designer coming out with you know, plus-size collection, that would be great.
Yeah, you could be part of the Malaysian Fashion Week one day.
Exactly.
I don't know whether you are.
That is my Everest, I'm telling you. So that is my Everest. I would love to actually get into Fashion Week, Malaysian Fashion Week, and actually, you know, get plus-size collection to be featured as one of their main collections. That would be great.
Mm-hmm. And also, in addition to that, we have this famous song going around, and it has become the mainstream, called All About That Bass. It's really famous, and love the lyrics and love the motivation, and she actually made herself very famous in the industry.
True. And she actually helped to be made aware that, you know, big girls are beautiful.
Yes.
Big girls are should be embracing their curves.
Mm-hmm.
And one more thing I would like to tell all our big girls out there, just because we are proud and we embrace our curves, do not judge or look down on others. We embrace each other. I always believe in, like, we accept and show our strength without putting down others.
Mm-hmm. So how can people actually access Fat is Fab?
Oh, you can go on Facebook. We're right now on www.facebook.com/fatisfab, FATISFAB. And everything is there, our events, our activities. You can even directly message us if you have any problems. We're there.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a website?
Not yet. Well,
not yet.
We did have, but due to lack of manpower at our site, we couldn't actually help to maintain it. So we're soon getting it up. And we have also plans to actually formalize FediFed next year. And please wish us luck. And we would love the support from everybody, especially the media.
Definitely.
Definitely.
We do support you because we love
the
motif.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
So what kind of topic you guys usually would talk about when you all meet together? Seems like a cool bunch of, you know, ladies hanging out.
Oh my god. When we get, because okay, FediStripe, we did the Plus Bazaar, so some of the vendors, the sellers there are grown quite close to us and we have a loyal following already. So we actually are quite loud when we meet. We talk about almost anything and everything. We don't only concentrate on negativity, like, you know, all these challenges. If we were to talk about it, we'll never finish. So what we do is we talk about positive stuff, you know, how to better ourselves, how to, you know, give motivation, or, you know, how to increase self-confidence among our consumers, our people, or the community. So yeah, it's a very proactive group, and we're all different kinds of personalities as well, so it's great. Yeah.
So you guys talk about virtually everything, including love, relationship, you know,
everything under the sun. Sometimes I cringe when I hear whatever I hear, but hey, everybody has the right to talk about everything.
Definitely.
And
yes.
I kind of like the idea that they're comfortable enough to actually talk about everything. Now that's good.
Mm-hmm. It's really great to hear that people can share, you know, their thoughts and ideas. But on the other hand, there are still some people who's out there, they don't have heard to talk about themselves, you know, to the public. How would you approach them to be able to encourage them to come to you guys and then talk about it?
Well, first things foremost, I think that is, I would like to actually talk about that angle where big girls do not have support from even some of them from their own family members, which is quite sad.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, my words are, please, you are not alone. Okay. Do reach out. Never shut in and you know, eat up inside.
Mm-hmm.
You're never alone. Whenever you think there's a big problem,
mm-hmm.
if you share it, the problem will seem like it's nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, just go to our page, all right, and contact any one of us. If you don't want to post anything on the page itself,
yep.
just message us directly, and one of us will come and help you. That's not a problem.
Just by looking at the pictures from the Facebook, and then I just checked out your website. It's called FediFed Rocks at WordPress. But do you have any videos? Because video can become very viral on YouTube or any other website. To promote more.
But now, not yet.
Mm-hmm.
We, like I said, we're strictly volunteers, so manpower is extremely a rare commodity to get.
Okay,
right,
I understand.
Now.
Yes.
Yeah, we do have lots of photos because our founder is his passion is photography.
I see.
That helps. Mm-hmm. In fact, we do have in mind that we want to actually start up a YouTube channel for,
yes.
you know, to actually talk about issues that's pertaining to body image issues.
Definitely,
that's where FediFed is heading, actually. Not just about fat, but body image issues as a whole.
Mm.
Because I can see some of the girls that actually came up in the Plus Bazaar is actually, those are not big, but they think they're big.
I think just like us.
It's how the media actually shapes our society.
I need to lose weight, you know, and I'm looking at you. You're beautiful as it is. What do you need to lose weight? If you think you're fat, what am I? Dinosaur? And they're like, they just laugh it off.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. So, yeah, we would like to address that issue. And we have tons of plans, but we have limited volunteers. We have limited funds, limited sources. Bear in mind, all activities that's done, especially the Plus Bazaar, is done without sponsors, without funding. Everything is all based on just our own, all the volunteers, my committee members.
That's great, yeah.
Yeah, so we really look forward to any form of support and to actually make all the plans that we have a reality.
You know, in fact, it just popped in my head. If you remember the movie called Titanic, back in those days, those chubby girls were considered pretty wealthy status in the society. But because of how the media is portraying, it has shaped our society in such a way that now all those big plus-size girls are really stressed.
And not just plus-size, even normal-size like me.
Exactly. Normal-sized girls are already getting stressed. Can you believe what the fat girls are going through? Okay, I mean, to me, it's all about self-confidence. I mean, to me, you don't need, I think the most important is you do not need anybody else's approval to live how you want to live your life.
But it's not easy when, it's not easy when the person that constantly telling that you are fat, you need to lose weight, is your either your parents or someone that is within your family circle.
That's why I say reach out outside of that. I am blessed that, yeah, my mom did tell me to lose weight, but for the right reasons. She's just afraid for my health.
Mm.
But once she saw that I'm happy and I'm actually trying to keep as healthy as I can, she accepted that fact.
Mm.
And this is what you call just standing up and telling them, look, I am trying to get healthy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm getting there, but I need your support as well. Ridicules are not helping. So when you voice it out, they get it. Oh, okay. Oh, I stepped over my boundary.
I see.
You know? So you need to step up. But one, I understand that's easier said than done.
Definitely.
For a lot of people.
Yes.
So that's why we have this self-confidence. We also have our very own volunteer basis, professional mental health care. Our psychiatrist that is actually getting on board to help us.
Mm-hmm.
Forming groups, help support groups, and also seminars and workshops on how to increase self-confidence from inside, from within you.
I see.
Because to me, the best motivator is yourself. If you depend on others to motivate you, they will tire out one day.
Mm-hmm.
But if you learn to motivate yourself, you are the best motivator ever.
Yeah. I think if I knew you probably like when I was in high school, which would probably be a decade and a half ago, I would probably thank you very much. Because
if I had a dollar for every time anyone say that, I would be rich right now.
I think I grew up always thinking that I'm fat, even though I'm not. It's just that mental idea that, you know, you have to look in a certain way. I think teenagers are the ones that are the most vulnerable to this kind of media attack or media influences.
Yeah. They're very much influenced. They're at the stage where they're forming their own personalities, their own ideas. So that's extremely crucial.
Mm-hmm. Last question. What is your favorite celebrity that, you know, inspire you or give you some sort of motivation? You know, being a plus size is not a hindrance to be be in the limelight.
Okay, mine is going to sound a bit cliche, but it's Oprah Winfrey.
Really? Oh,
she's a great person.
Yeah, because I'll tell you why. Because I always follow her. And there's one she said about, you know, she's always talking about self-motivation, self-esteem, yeah? And she always said, look at me, okay? I'm a big girl, I'm black, and I'm not very pretty, but I still made it. Now, that statement actually is a wake-up call for me. Okay, she actually said she's got three challenges that she has to go through, and she still made it. She went through all the odds, and she made it big.
Yep.
So if she can do it, why can't we? You know,
and then she is the one who actually shaped the society, you know, how beautiful she can be.
So I really admire her. I admire her tenacity. I admire her confidence, her boldness. And I actually feed off from that. And I try to actually give back to the community as much as I can.
So with that, thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you so much for the support. Thank you so much
giving
us the opportunity to spread our message here.
It was really fun and a really pleasure to have you.
Thank you
so much. Thanks, Arlene. Thanks, Grace.
Have a good day.